Hi there, this is Imaneo. Welcome to my channel. In this series, we implemented a color switch game replica using Flutter and Flame Game Engine. This is the final episode, and in this episode, we are going to wrap it up and doing some minor things, performance improvements or killing ups and these kind of things. So let's jump into the code. At first, let's take a look at the latest state of the game. Now let's compare it with the demo that we showed in the first episode of the series. Let me open it here. Yeah, the first thing is that these particles are, I think they are more than us and they are bigger than our stars. This is the first difference. Oh, by the way, the second one is that we have this text here which says score equals 1, but here we have just a number here. So we need to make it center. This is the second difference. Yeah, and the third difference is that we need to add more circular rotators to make a real game. You know, in a real game you have infinite circular rotators in the game. Okay, at first let me remove the background music to have more focus on the implementation. So it was in the main game, yes, and here we can comment out this code. Okay, and the first thing is that we need to make the score component or score text in the top center of the page. It's here we have a row and we can have a separate alignment for this. We can say alignment is alignment the top center and child is this. Also here we don't need a row anymore, we just return it here. It is top left, and also here we need safe area to prevent it drawn on top of the status bar. Okay, so it is center. And I think we need to add some shadows here. Black offset is black 45. We need to remove the offset and let's change it to a white to see the effect. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine for now. And the second change is the particles. So to do that, I'm going to comment the circular rotators. Circular rotator and also color switchers. Okay, now we have only stars, and let me add more of them to be able to test with more stars. Okay, I think it's enough. And now let me modify it a little. Yes, we have a sprite size is size divided by 2, maybe we can change it divided by or size times 0.9. yeah, they are bigger. What if we use the same size of the component? It feels good actually. And what if we decrease the lifespan to something like 800 milliseconds? Yeah, I think that is fine. And let me revert back this code. Okay. Great. Now let's add more of circle rotators. We need to move the camera upward to see the result. To do that, I will find an update method here. Yeah, I think that is fine. And we can manually change the camera position to a vector 2 of 0 and minus 400 to see. Yes, minus 500. Okay, and now I will copy paste a star component as circle rotator together, and I will put it on minus 800 maybe. Okay, it is too far, maybe minus 600. It is too close, so we will go with minus 700. Or maybe 750, and then we can add a color changer here. We can have a color switcher in minus 500. Okay, and then let's add another one. You know, it is better to generate it automatically when you move the camera, but for now we just create some of them manually to have something like a real game. So that's why we are doing it manually. And the next one is in minus 900 maybe. Let me comment out these two. 950. Yes, and let me move the camera to another position. Let me uncomment these two, and position should be like minus 1200. Maybe 1000. Oh, no. Like this. Okay, and let's add another circle rotator here to have two circle rotators at the same position, but size is different. We will have it 200 to see. 220. Okay, I think that is fine. Let me remove this code to move the camera in the actual position, and let's play it. Yeah, we have enough challenges for a sample game. And yeah, the next thing that we need to do is performance improvement on assets. So when you load an asset, for example, in the ground file, we are loading a sprite from our assets directory. So in a sprite, when it wants to load, it uses flame.images. This is the caching system. I read it from here. I will put the link in the description. It says when you want to cache something, you can load them in the memory. So in this way, instead of loading it from asset directory, which takes a little time, you can load it when the game starts, and whenever you want to show it, it immediately retrieves that data from memory and shows it in the game. So I'm going to find our main file here, and we can, yeah, in the my game unload here, we can do some caching. At first, let me await on the super unload. Then we can say, what was that? Also, it has a load all method, which we can use to pass a list of icons. So the first one is finger tap PNG, and we can search for others. The second one is star icon.png. Yeah, this way we load the images when the game starts, and Flame shows them immediately when we want to show them. And the next step, we are going to do the same for audio and sound effects. If you open the audio documentation, there's a section called caching, and here it says you can use Discord to cache the sound effects and musics. So I'm going to copy paste this code. Again, we have a load all. We can pass a list of files here. As I remember, we have something in the game file. Yeah, it is the commented code, and it has background.mp3, and also we have something else. Oh, the other one is .wav. Yeah, this is collect.wav file. And yeah, if you check the play method of audio player Flame Audio, you see that it uses the audio cache. So that is why if you put them here, so Flame knows where to find them to load the cached ones. And if we run the game, yeah, we have more performance here. So the next step is to prevent recreation of paint objects. So as you remember, we are recreating some paint objects in our render methods. I'm going to find them, for example, in the maybe a star component. Yeah, here, for example, we have a paint. So I'm going to find all of them. Yeah, we have four of them. So the better approach is to cache them. I mean, we can create them in the constructor paint for particle. And maybe we can, yeah, the instance is enough. We don't need to add any other properties. And instead of recreating it, we can access the created one. And also we have same thing in the circle rotator. Yeah, it is in circle arc. So we can have a final arc paint maybe, and instead of creating a paint, we are going to reuse the created one. And the other thing is in color switcher component, I'm gonna use a paint variable here. Yes, and the other one is in player. Okay, let's run to see what happened. everything seems good. Okay, I think we are done with this series. So we learned together how to implement a color switch game replica using Flutter and Flame Game Engine. We did it step by step. We explained some concepts. And if you learned something, please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe the channel. We are going to create more contents in the game area, or maybe I will record some videos about FL chart, because FL chart is the package that I developed, and I can create some contents about the FL chart package. And also, don't forget to write me your feedback. You know, I'm new in the YouTube and I want to improve myself, and your feedback is a great and is a big help to me to realize what parts of the video or myself can be improved in the future. Thank you very much. I hope you have a great day or night wherever you are. Thank you. Bye bye.